In the words of the Persian epic poet Ferdowsi, all over Iran is my abode. From the majestic snow-capped Damavand peak to the scorching desert in the heart of Iran, and from the lush woods of the Caspian coast to the azure blue waters of the Persian Gulf. Praising the unique and compassionate God has been practiced in Iran for thousands of years. And Zoroastrians, Jews, Christians, and Muslims have lived alongside each other in peace and harmony for centuries. And I've had the privilege of carrying their hymns of monotheism from their places of worship to distant corners of the country, bearing in mind the lyrics by the superb Persian poet Hafez. Everyone, sober or besotted, seeks the beloved side. Everywhere, mosque or synagogue, love does reside. Today, it's time for the great congregation of Armenian Christians at and around St. Thaddeus Church in northwestern Iran. The heart of Iran's religious rituals, however, is the holy city of Mashhad. Where the shrine of Imam Reza, the 8th Imam of the Shia Muslims, is located. Hospitable people of Yazd have built fascinating wind catchers to take me home as their guest. I enter their homes through these wind catchers, caress the water gently, and provide them with cool air at no expense. The prudent Iranians living in this region are against the culture of waste. For instance, Water is brought here from distant aquifers through underground canals called kanats, so that this source of life is not evaporated or wasted in the very heart of the burning desert. As far as I can remember, the oldest of these kanats were made more than 2,000 years ago. Today, in addition to kanats, modern methods like pressurized and drip irrigation systems are also being utilized. They help produce delicious pomegranates, juicy grapes, and the globally popular and exotic Iranian pistachios for everyone to enjoy.